Alright, so we're working on build. We started last week. And we're just gonna dive right in. But for everybody that didn't get to see what it looked like, I'll show you around a little. My back deck here, as you can see, she's got a dog and a cat. So there's a dog door in the back. All of our windows up. Our layout. And everything for the actual structure is done. We even have some walls in now. We just have to... Hi, everyone! We have to go in and do the walls and flooring. So, we're kind of doing this modern yet country feel. And I want you guys to help. So we're going to discuss in chat what flooring and wall colors we want to use. So if you have any suggestions, go ahead and put that down in the bottom in the chat, and I'll be watching for them. Sorry, my Twitch wall is a little behind. So it's not letting me actually see you guys yet. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and just dive right in and look at some wall colors while my chat tries to catch up, because I can't see you guys, anything that you're saying, unfortunately. Alright, so this is actually the kitchen area back here. It's gonna be an eat-in kitchen, actually. What we're gonna do is go ahead and put the same wallpaper in the pantry as well. And while I'm in here, we're gonna do the flooring too. I'm gonna use this one. And I think we'll carry that flooring into the hallway here as well. So we're going to do a wall color for the hallway here as well. I want it to kind of match the kitchen, but I don't want it to be exact. So we're going to go with this one, I think. Alright, now for the living room. think we're gonna go with a nice shade of maybe green. I don't really like that one. Kind of playing with colors a little. I think yellow would actually be better. I'm gonna go yellow. What are you guys' thoughts? I'm not sure I like it with the flooring. Maybe. I think you're referring to the flooring. Sorry, my chat just came up on my screen. I was having issues with, like, commercials popping up. I really like this flooring. I'm not sure how I feel about this wallpaper within the living room, though. Any suggestions? Do you like it? I don't really care for this flooring, I think, myself. Maybe like this one. It's like a creamy orangish color. Alright, so we have this creamy-ish color here. It's kind of like a peach. I think it works really well with this flooring. So I think I'm going to keep that for now. I might play around with that a little bit later. I changed it. It was yellow for a moment, and I went with this peachy color right here. I didn't like the yellow with the floor, but I'm not sure. I think it's the lighting, honestly. So this would be the yellow. I like the idea of yellow with all the windows. Is that better? I think I'm gonna keep the yellow. I'm gonna put the yellow back. All right, so right now we have, this was the master bedroom, and that was the master bathroom and the office back here. I'm thinking either this peachy color in the master bedroom, or we could do maybe green. Do we like the green or the peach color better for the bedroom? Well, we decide between that peach and the green for the bedroom. I'm gonna go ahead and pick a wall color for the office. I'm gonna put blue in the office back here. And I'm gonna put the walls down for a moment, so that I can do the flooring in the bathrooms, because I have kind of an idea of what I want to do in those. I just want to see how it looks before I decide. I like this one for this bathroom. Green? Okay. I do really like that green. I use it a lot. To do the brighter green or the lighter green. This one. They're both pretty bright. I think this green might be better. So for the bathroom over here, I have this linoleum tile in here, and I'm thinking maybe the, I think that's too much. I don't really care for that in there. I might change it to tile now that I'm looking at it. With the tile walls. I really wanted tile walls in here. I'm gonna use this tile wall. So we're gonna change the flooring to tile. Go darker with the floor, I think. Then we can look at it next to the other flooring, and I think that looks good. So we have our other bathroom back here. And since we've got green going on in the wallpaper in the master bathroom, or bedroom, I want the bathroom to kind of match. So we're gonna do some green. That is a little too much. I really like this one. We're gonna do that one. I'm gonna look at some green carpeting as well. Don't want anything too busy. So what do you guys think? It would be either this dark one, this one, or this one with the swirls. I think I kind of like the one with the swirls or this one. I think this one might be too dark. I'll let you guys think while I do the floors back here. We're going to actually just put this one back here. I think I like the plain one better because the flooring in the bathroom is pretty simple. That way you can put an area rug in there too and it just won't overpower it. Alright, so we actually have our wallpapers and our flooring done for the entire build now. You like the swirly carpet? This one? You know, I did too. So we're going to go with that, and I think a carpet, an area rug will just work just fine with that. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to work on the little bathroom here. So we're going to put the walls down so we can see what we're doing a little bit. And we're going to go into our bathroom items. And don't want them to all be green. The walls are gray and the flooring gray. We're gonna add a little bit of color with our accents. So you can see the wall. Alright, so we're gonna go white with all of our items. So we'll start with the shower. This one is one of my favorites actually. It is like the best shower out of all of these as far as the hygiene level. You see, it's odd that it's all the way down here because of that, but it's there. So we're gonna add a bathtub in as well. And keeping with our theme here of spa day, we're gonna go ahead and add the spa day bathtub as well. And I'm thinking the lighter gray for this. And I want to add a wall to separate them. So we're going to put one right there. And I don't want to forget. So we're going to go ahead and do the wallpaper for that. Alright, so we need a sink and a toilet. We're going to use this one. And the toilet, I'm going to do the same spa day. I don't care for the light gray on the toilet, so we're going to go this color, the black and white. And for the sink, I actually don't like that light gray either, so we're going to go black. Let's do our mirror and we'll add in our accents. Hi, Allie. It's okay. Welcome to chat. All right. We're going to do the towels. I'm going to add in the black one. We're going to actually put two of them here. Just like the look of having two of them right there. We're going to do our items here on the sink. Like the soap dispenser. And we'll go over here and we'll grab the toothbrush. I don't know about you guys, but it drives me crazy that this clutter item is over in this category, and like the other bathroom items that are technically clutter too are in the exits. I think it should be together, but that's me. So we're gonna add in actually a bucket here. And then we'll turn. This is a smaller bathroom, so sorry guys, the angle is a little off a little. There we go. We're gonna add in our towel for the bathtub. Yeah, phones, they have not been cooperating lately. I know you ladies have been having trouble with yours lately. Both of you. Alright, so we have most of our accents already done. We're going to keep it kind of simple. We're going to do our bath mats. And on the back of the bathroom door, I'm going to actually put our bathrobe. There we are. So we need a piece of artwork for over the bathtub here. Sorry, we're zooming in and out all over the place. Thanks, Allie. I need to decide what to put into the office space. If you guys have any suggestions, I'm looking to see maybe if we should just keep it an office or maybe add in some other items like an art area, exercise equipment, things like that. You guys have any suggestions on that? That would be great. I'm gonna do the butterflies, I think. Add a little pop of color there. And we need a curtain because it kind of looks out into the front porch. Don't want anything as an open view with that. Needing this one. Maybe in a different color. I prefer this color, but I don't know. What do you guys think? I don't know that it's as modern as I'd want it to be. Maybe this one instead. We can shrink it down. I actually kind of like the lighter color with that, but I'm not sure if I like the texture that's going on there. Maybe I'll just do some shears. That would be better. That is a great idea, Allie. Add a futon looking couch to make it kind of like a spare bedroom. That would be so cute. All right, so the bathroom there is done. That is our spare guest bathroom. I didn't add any plants actually to this bathroom like I usually do, but that's okay. So what we're gonna do, because we're gonna put plants in the hallway here, I didn't want to overpower it. There's going to be a lot of plants. We're going to go on into the master bathrooms. So we're working on bathrooms. We'll do that. I'm going to actually use the same shower, but in a different color. And the bathtub I'm going to go with, actually, is this one. I'm gonna put it over here. So I'm gonna go ahead and do our rugs for the bath mats. I'm not sure that I like the way they overlap. I'll pull it over just a tad bit. That's perfect. They're not sticking out or anything. And we'll do our towels. Thinking all white. And we're gonna add this guy right here. We can go ahead and do our curtains while we're in here. Since we did shears in the other bathroom, I think we'll do shears in this bathroom too. Plain white. What do you guys think of the white? I think it blends in too much with the walls. I don't like that at all with this color now. Alright, Allie. We'll see you in a minute. Mm-hmm. These actually work better, I think. We're gonna go with these. I like how they stand out here. I like the silver accent. And because we have the bigger window here, we can actually put this up here. And not have to size it any. Perfect. So we're gonna actually put in counters over here. So we're gonna go back to our bathroom. And we're gonna put countertop. Thinking this one in gray or the black. What do you guys think? Gray or black? We'll leave that like that. What we decide. I'm gonna go ahead and put the sink in. So we can always change that. And we'll let you see what it looks like with the sink. I'm gonna go ahead and do the mirror while I'm over here. And I'm gonna go into lighting. So I'm gonna add these into the mix. The corner over here, and I'm gonna add a plant over in the other corner for this bathroom. I kind of know which one I'm looking for. There. So we're gonna do our towels for the wall. Do a towel for the counter. Put our hand soap. And then we'll go back over here and grab our toothbrushes. They're all the way over there. Keep it nice and simple. Going to go ahead and add in a hamper. Thinking this one. I'm going to put it in the corner. And our bathrobe on the wall. So we have it. It's coming together. I actually kind of like having the cabinet here. We'll do the white. And we're going to add in one more rug right here in front of the sinks. Actually grab it here. So we have not put our toilet in yet. So we're going to go in here and we're going to grab the toilet. Let's see. I kind of like this one. It's going to run into the window a little bit, but I think it'll be okay. Need our toilet paper holder, and we will do a little garbage can in this bathroom. I'm gonna put that right there, right over the garbage can. So, what do you guys think of the cabinet colors? Does it work with the black or the gray? I think the black would be better with the wallpaper and the flooring. And then we can use a little artwork right over the bathtub here. We're actually going to go in and pick something from Spa Day for the art. Nice and simple. I think we will do one of these planters on the wall here. Alright, so there we have it. It's almost finished. We're gonna do lighting. And we're gonna get rid of these for a moment so we can do that. We did not change the lighting in the other bathroom. We didn't want to. We are going to in this bathroom though. We're going to use this one right there in front of the sinks. And for the actual bathtub area, I think we're actually going to get rid of this and put one of the ones that lights up on the wall. We're going to use the bigger one, I think. Maybe not. I'm thinking gray. Maybe the lighter gray. It's more white with the black. Okay, we're gonna do that. And we're gonna add a light right above the bathtub. Okay, so the bathroom here is finished. We're going to go ahead and save, just so that we don't lose anything. So we finished two bathrooms so far. And we're going to move into the office space. I love the idea of having a sofa that's kind of like a futon. So we're going to kind of look through the color options here. We're going to use this chair. That's like the futon one. We're going to look at the colors. Kind of like the black and white, or maybe like the blue and white. I think the blue and white may even look better in this room. And since we kind of have like a mission style furniture piece, we're going to pick a side table that's going to match over here and over there. So back to our lighting. I love these lights from our bowling one, bowling pack, if you guys haven't seen them. They match the sofa so well. So those are what we're going to use. Oh, you're fine, Allie. No worries. We're going to do our curtains while we're in here. And I'm thinking maybe a blue. Or a white. Maybe something with both even. Now, keep in mind that she's got pets. I'm thinking maybe this one would be really cute. The colors work really well. It's kind of fun. We're going to flip the room here so we can see these curtains better over here. think that would be perfect. Maybe shrink them down a little. I like them the bigger size. I wish they kind of like actually go over the window a little bit better, but it's okay. We're gonna go and pick our bookshelf, and I'd like it to be white. I kind of like this one here from our Seasons pack, because it has that open shelving feel there, like the Mission furniture matches the sofa really well. Thanks, Ellie. I like those too. And then we need to do, let's put the walls back down so we can see a little better for space. We need to pick a desk. And I think white might be better since we have a lot of white, and then add in the color accents like the rug and things like that. Let's see. We could either use this one. There's this one. Or we could even go more simple, like with just the white. That one. Do you guys have a favorite? Oh, that's okay, B. I know you guys have been having issues with your phones lately. It's not a big deal. Well, we're kind of deciding on which of these three desks to use. I'm going to boom the drawers. See, I really like that one too, because everything is pretty open here, and it gives the idea of like having something closed in. This one from Seasons, yeah, with the branches kind of look to it. This one I think is just too much white. It's just bland, it has no like detail at all. But these, actually the wood matches better too. Let's see. And we could kind of put it like out in the corner, because we're making it like it's supposed to be a futon and it would have to open up. We don't want like a desk like in the way. So do we like, I think we like the one with the drawers the best. So we're going to go ahead and add this lamp onto the desk as well. And we'll go back in here. We'll go ahead and grab our computer now while we're in here. I like one with the yellow. Use that. So we have our chairs. I'm thinking either blue or white. I don't think I want one on wheels, although this one would work. I think I'd rather have one that is more comfortable, maybe with padding. See, we have like this one. It doesn't have the padding, but it is like a comfortable kind of cozy feel to it for the room. These have the padding, but the color doesn't really work as well. And I'd rather add a pop of color to it if I was going to use one with padding. I don't like that one at all. It's like silver. That one, no. Look at the sofa too while we're deciding, so we can actually see kind of what it looks like. Where's this one? It's kind of cute. Has a cozy kind of feel to it. Do we like that one, or do we like this one here? Those are the two options I have so far. Or we could actually go just blue, but I think that might be too much. It doesn't really match this blue as well as I'd like. So we're just gonna go ahead and get rid of that one. These are super cute chairs we might use in the living room, but not in this room. So we'll go ahead and put like one of these over here for now while we're deciding. Maybe use it in the dining room at the dining table. You want it at the desk? Yeah, I do too. It gives it like a softer feel. So we'll go ahead and do an area rug. I kind of want to go with those colors still. I like this one. It matches the design on the lamp. So I think we're going to throw that down there. And we'd want a round one, I think, underneath the desk. In white. Under the chair. And then I think I'd like to add an easel over here. And we can add a globe as well. It's like an office. I think I'd rather have the globe over there than the easel. I don't want to clutter it. So we need items for our bookshelves. So we're going to go in and look at some clutter items and decide what we want to put. Let's see. Like a stack of books there as well. Then we want to add our pencil cup to the desk. I usually do. And I think we'll add this guy over here. And a tissue box. So the desk area is done. So now we're gonna go in here and do our shelves. Pop of color there. Basket. A few books. More books over here. Yeah, framed art on the stand would be cute. Although I do have a sim currently living in this house, so technically we could make like artwork to put on there and go from there. We're gonna put some cookbooks here. So I actually want to make sure they're actually like, on the shelf. And not like floating there. Because I'm pretty sure those are like floating there. They look like they're floating. But then they go through the shelf. So yeah, just one down. That's perfect. Alright, so we're gonna do the butterfly, I think, over here. Moving. I don't necessarily like it there with the cookbooks. So I'm gonna take the cookbooks away. We can put those in the kitchen, on the counter. We're gonna pull some I'm gonna go in decorative and pull some plants out, I think. Let's see. I think I'd use this one. Perfect, so I don't want it to go through the actual shelf. That's funny, Allie. Your dogs and cats sound like they're having a good old time. I'm going to add the dog planter here. I really like this one, and the cat. Contemplating making the cat one over here, even though I have this one, because I like it so much, but I think it might be too much for this space. Alright, so what we're going to do, we need to add some artwork to the walls, but we also have some other things to do here too. First, we're gonna go ahead and do the over the wall here. Well, over the desk here. We're gonna add a couple of pieces. So we're not gonna make this functional. We're gonna just close it in. It's gonna be more decorative than anything. And I think I do actually want to put something here that's not just artwork. Okay, guys, have any suggestions what we could put over on the side? We don't want to block the futon. Thinking maybe a chess set. Actually, I haven't used one of those in a little while. Or maybe like a decorative screen, like one of these. Well, we think about that. I am going to continue with finding the one piece of art that I was gonna find. That's a good idea. Switch these two. Kinda like this. We like that better. It shows in a mirror. That would be really cute. I agree. I'm gonna go ahead and pull that piece of art that I was gonna put over here out first. Actually, I actually have one in mind. I don't know if I can remember where it was. I don't know what pack it was. That'd make it a lot easier to find it. But it looks like map. And I know it when I see it. Here it is. So yeah, we'll look at mirrors. A wall mirror would be really cute. Or we could do like the floor mirror like this. Maybe something a little distressed. We did it in white. Everything's kind of white. I think maybe the distressed white one would be better. I'm not seeing one that's distressed. I kind of like the dark blue. Stands out just enough. And then we can go ahead and add the shelves. Let's see. Maybe these would be really kind of cute. See, I like this mirror, but I'm thinking if I use these shelves, it won't work really well. I'm thinking maybe doing something more like built in. Move that over there a minute. I think that's too much shelving. Kind of playing with it a little bit now. Just gonna look at an inventory for a moment. We could always do something like these shelves. But, you know, I don't think I'm going to fill the shelves completely either. Because she could, like, put all of her collectible things on there. Like those little figures that you go around and you collect. I think this would work better. Space them out a little. That's too small. I don't want to have to size the mirror because they never look right when you do. Might just do like a row of them and maybe mirror above it. It's not big enough. I think my problem is that it's the shelves and not open here. I love this idea of doing shelves with mirror. Try something here with maybe a planter at the base. I think I like that, but it runs into the chair. I don't like the shelves there, but I like the base. I don't think it's right for this room though. Maybe another build. Alright, we will figure this out. There are a lot of mirrors. Which mirror? Wall plants, yeah. I love wall plants. And I'm thinking maybe of putting plants on the shelves too. Because I like the idea of the shelves with the mirror idea. I'm thinking it's just the wrong shelves, maybe even the wrong mirror. Well, maybe not. I will go back in here and we'll do the wall plants to see what we think. We can look at the various wall plants. There's all kinds of options. Like these are some of my favorites. They work really well with like the color in the carpet. And the blue. In the rug just kind of shows up in the mirror. I love that it does that. So I think the mirror actually works really well there. It makes the room feel bigger. Now we could use those plants. I like the idea of the flowers there. I think these wouldn't work with the room. There was the option of this one. If we would like to just do something with ivy. So what do we think? Do we like this one or this one for the wall plants? I'll let you guys think about that. We also have this one as an option, which we could actually kind of probably put like here. That adds a little something more to the mirror. The green and blue. Yeah, I think I do too. Even though this color's in the rug, this one I think would look better in that space. Maybe framing it. Well, I could put something different here on this side. Kind of do like this up here though. Could even put like a different piece of art over here. Maybe a clock. Let's put this here for a moment. I do like that color there. And that actually works really well right there. The two over here. And we can change out the lighting. We want something that is going to work better with this space. Kind of have the bowling ones going on here, so I mean, we could go with that. And maybe this color. It's not very bright though. I really kind of like these as well. And the colors work really well. So we're gonna use those, I think, and get rid of these two. Maybe add a few more in here. Maybe I'm just, no, I'm so OCD about spacing. I like that better. I think we need to go in. Yeah, that's perfect. Alright, so this room is done. And I like how we have all of the plants and stuff in there as well. It's not overpowering. So we're gonna actually use this lighting in this hallway too. And get rid of these. And now that I'm looking at this bathroom, I kind of want to change that light out, honestly, to a different one. I want this one. So we have our lights in the hallway. And we're going to add some plants while we're in here, and maybe a rug. I'm going to go back to our decorations. We'll do our rug first. I really love this rug from the Seasons. And since we're kind of doing a lot of plants, we don't want it that big. I think this one would work really well. But I do not like the way they intersect there either. So we're just gonna use the one. So you can see there is the window area here. So like I don't really wanna block that with anything. But I do wanna put a fish tank in here. Let's see. I know where it is. I think it's in past it. There we are. Fish tank. So we're actually going to add a bench over here in front of the windows. And let's see, I want to use one with white, maybe a little pop of color to it, I don't know that I like that. Thanks. I really like this layout too. I kind of played with it a little bit as we were streaming last week. I kind of like this bench here, but I do not like the rug right there. So we're getting rid of it. Surprisingly, I don't like the rug. It's one of my favorites. So we're going to put some curtains here in the hallway. I'm glad you guys love the layout. We're gonna use these. We're gonna go ahead and throw our plants over here. There's gonna be like one right there. Actually, I'm gonna put it over here. I have an idea of what I'm looking for, but I'm not sure yet exactly. Put one in front of that planter. don't like that one. Thinking about taking that one out of there to put something else there. Like that one. I want it to be pretty simple. Nothing too crazy. I'm not sure how I feel about the plants there. I think I want to move on. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to put our plant here. And then our bench back where it was. We're going to do a little rug. We're gonna play with this a little bit and see what we think. I don't like that at all. If you guys have any suggestions on what kind of rug you'd like to see in this space, feel free to let me know. Now, this is one of my favorites. I've used it in other rooms before. Need to pull it out somehow. Not sure how I feel about this plant. I really don't like it right there. I think we're gonna skip having a plant there altogether. We're gonna put it in the corner in the kitchen because I do like this plant. So there's the little sitting area and they can look at the fish. We need some artwork on the wall here. There's something here on the wall. So I'm kind of thinking. Oh, thank you. I'm going to use these, I think. Because I want to add some kind of plants to this area. Dang, a unique shape. Maybe. Let's see. Let's see how I feel about this. I like it. I think I might take it up to the top and see how it looks. Alright guys, what do you think? All the way up? I don't know how I feel about that. Maybe with this rug instead. I like this one too. I think it matches the bench better. There we are. We have plants. We can see them. Here we are. I think maybe I need to move them closer together. Thank you. grab the right one. That would be helpful. Great, that's as close as it's gonna get, I think. Because I keep adjusting it. Okay, that's good. I like it. Great, so the hallway here is done almost. We have one little wall here. I want to put a piece of artwork. And since it's kind of more natural feel in the hallway here, the colors, we're going to use our butterfly. Something nice and simple. And there's our hallway. It is complete. So we're going to go ahead and do the pantry next. We're going to go in and grab our shelves that I'm going to use in there. So we're going to take down the wall, actually, so we can see better. Let's see, I believe it is in the miscellaneous. I always struggle when I have to find this because I always forget where I put it. Oh, it might be in your storage. Let's see. Here first. There it is. And I want to use this color. So that's going to be our storage shelves. We're gonna go back to decorations and we're gonna fill this thing up. We're gonna put various things in here that she would definitely use. Like, she needs cat food. And we need a dog food. Let's see. Blue. We're going to put this on the shelf. And she's going to use, we'll put this one over here actually, because we're going to put the dog and cat treats in here. Baskets. Use the tote. I love this piece. But I think it's way too big. I've never used it this size. So we're going to shrink it down. We're going to put it up here on the shelf. Maybe a little bit bigger. That's perfect. And add some pots up here too. Well, maybe it doesn't want to cooperate. So we're going to see what we can do here. I could play with that longer, but you know, honestly, I don't feel like it. So we're not going to. Instead, we're going to put some gardening stuff up here. There's so many items that we can put in there. Thanks, Allie. I appreciate it. Put some pans there. so we're going to have to move this out for a moment, but I want to make sure that it will land where I want it to. I did not move that out far enough. Okay. So I'm gonna move this back. Is it floating in the air? Yeah, it's kind of floating in the air. So we're gonna fix that. There we go. So we're gonna move this out of the way. We're gonna do the same thing here. We're going to move these up. Flip them around. And then we're just gonna have to kind of play it by ear a little bit until we know exactly where they need to land. High, because we're kind of comparing it to the basket. Perfect. So we have all of our clutter here behind the doors. Alright, so we're gonna go back in. And we're gonna find our parent board. Because even though she doesn't have kids here yet, she will eventually. There we go. It's perfect. We're gonna actually duplicate the planter on this side. So there we have our little entrance area into the hallway and bathroom. And we're gonna do our cat and dog bowls over here. So we kinda need two, because we've got the two pets. I mean, technically we could use the same one, but we're not going to. Makes it more difficult for them to eat. I'm just gonna go in here and pull the little mats out. I like the contrasting colors here, so we're going to do that. And there's like their little feeding area. We're going to do artwork above it for the pets. Let's see. See, the artwork from this pack of cats and dogs is really cute if you want to add like a vet office, but it doesn't work for your home exactly. Like, they're all vet pieces. This is kind of cute, and this one is kind of cute, so we're gonna add those. I kind of wish we could change the border color, make it white, but you can't. And we're gonna use this garbage can. We're gonna put it right here. She's not using the parent board now anyway. And there's our dog door. Over here is going to be where all of the cabinetry really is. We're going to put the dining area over here, so we're going to go ahead and do that now. And we may finish the kitchen next time. I kind of want a round table for this space, and I love the idea of a gray table. Our doggy is going to have to move. Okay. So we need some chairs for this table. Do you guys have any suggestions? We do have this one that we kind of put out here. That we can use these. We may want to change the color of the chair, so. I really like the flowers, so. I'm not sure how I feel about the black. We can always change the color of the table. The white's really cute. We can go white. I think I like that. Here we go. Doggy, I'm sorry, we keep moving you. We're going to put a rug. Don't really like that one for this. We do want a round rug though. That's not quite what we're looking for either. I think we're gonna go with the one. I'm not in those colors. Maybe just white. I like it. I think it works. Put the table on his head. I kind of did actually. Going to put this over here, and actually I think right here, because what I want to do is I want to go back in and add this piece actually in this color too, and we're going to go and grab some items from the kitchen. I love to put that there. I usually do that, or I put this. I think I'm going to do is put another one of these plates. Bring in more of the flowers. And I want that fruit bowl, the round one. For the table. And I passed it. There it is. So we can do some window curtains. Some window curtain stuff. Okay. Let's see. We could actually do these that matched in the office. Which is kind of cute. Or we could do more of a solid color. That is too big, first of all, and I don't really care for that color in this room. I think it would have to be the white, but I don't like the gold. More like this, but we would need shorter. It's gonna cooperate. It wants to go all the way up on the ceiling. So, this is what we'll do. It's gonna move with it. Well, that didn't work. I don't really care for that honestly either, anyway, so maybe something that's more sheer. or just solid white. I think I like that one better. What do you guys think of the black curtain rod piece? Do you guys like that? I'm not sure how I feel about that particular part of it. But we're gonna go with it for now. There we go. I don't know how you send it up so low. You're supposed to be up higher. Okay. And these are gonna actually just stay open, I think. You like the gold better? Yeah, I kinda do too, actually, now I'm looking at these black. I think it's just not. This doesn't look great with all of the white. So it's the gold then. I have to fix that one over here. They make kind of funny. There we go. So yeah, there's the gold. So we have this set up now, the dining area. I think we're gonna actually move it out a little bit to grab the rug in the right place. So we put it right on top of the dog, and she stayed there. Oh my gosh, it's going right through her head. See, there's her poor little head. She's definitely a unicorn now. Oh, poor doggy. Okay, so there's that, and I think we need like a bench or something right here in front of the window, now that we moved it over. So we're going to add a bench over here. See how it looks first, and if we don't like it, I'm gonna take it away. I don't know how I feel about the black cushion, but I like the white. I like the idea of that style bench because it's thinner for the space, and it could be like a shelf for cookbooks. What do you guys think? I think it looks okay there. Right, that poor dog. Poor doggy. Alright, so we're already in here. We're gonna go ahead and this is just gonna be a longer stream this time. We're gonna go ahead and do the kitchen area over here. Because I wanna go ahead and finish this room. I'm gonna do the fridge here. And the stove is actually going to go here because we want to put the hood vent over it. We're going to use the same color for the stove. And I want to use this vent actually. We're gonna have high upper cabinets, I think. Because I have so many windows over here. I'm actually thinking that maybe I need to do it with the curtains right there since I decided to put the stove against the wall. But I think maybe I'm changing my mind about putting the stove against the wall. I think I'm gonna build it into the island. A rounded piece for the end of these cabinets. I So we're gonna move the stove over. And we're gonna actually get rid of that bit. Wait, I'm thinking about it. I want to move this over here. We're gonna slide the stove back in there a little bit. And we're going to do our piece there. And we'll do our sink here as well. Don't really like the blue though, so I'm thinking. I think we're gonna change that sink better. I'm gonna grab the mat that I always use too for in front of the cooking area. And we're going to grab this one above the stove. So we're gonna get rid of that light. So we can go back in here and add some chairs in front of the bar. We're gonna do these. So I want this to go here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna move some stuff here. That might work actually, now that I've got it rearranged a little. But I didn't want the square one. It doesn't want to cooperate. That's not bad actually. It overlaps a little. It's not terrible. It'll work. I mean, if I shrink this a tiny bit. No, we don't want it bigger. It's better. Okay, so this is our start so far to our kitchen. We're going to add some lower cabinets over here. Apparently I decided I was going to close it. Actually, I'm gonna do a table instead. Pick a buffet. I do not like the blue at all on that. I like the idea of the buffet table there. Or I could do a bar. What do you guys think? Maybe even both. I don't think they need a very big bar. I'm thinking like this one, like for drinks. Yeah, I kind of created a conundrum over here with my spacing. I think I like the bar in the corner and maybe the fridge in the middle. And I have to figure some stuff out. I really like the windows here, but maybe I do with the curtains. But if I do that, it's kind of silly just to have one curtain up in the whole room. That is a tough choice. I've caused myself a little bit of grief over here. It's quite amusing. I could do like a little table there. And what I was thinking was the drink fountain. But I have to raise it up to do that. No, apparently it won't let me. I thought I did that with this table before. I don't think it was that table. I'm wondering if it was like this table. Maybe. It might not have been. Oh, I know which one it was. Never mind. Is this one. This color here. Make it stand out a little. Seems so big though with the pantry right there. Yeah, I really could. I think I'm gonna have to because I'm not digging the way this looks over here, so I'm gonna get rid of it and do the countertops. But this time we're going to do this countertop. We're actually going to get rid of this. And we're going to make this the end of the countertop actually. So we're gonna change this color actually so that they match. Because I prefer that. Yeah, these work really well with the flooring. Never mind, I'm gonna keep it. And I'm all over the place. It's funny because I never have this much issue with like kitchens. I usually know what I want when I go into it. actually like that better with the upper cap that's white and the bottom one's a color. So we're gonna do that. Which means the stove is gonna become blue. There it is. It's blue. And it's gonna stay silver. And like our cabinet over here changed. As you can see, we are going to fix this. And make it round as well. Perfect. So this will be like where our microwave and that goes over here. I'm going to put a coffee pot. And we will do an ice cream maker. And a popcorn maker over here. I think I want them to be like a lighter blue. And these will just be white. Mm-hmm. So we're going to grab the little decor piece that goes in the corner that is like the mugs. There it is, I crossed it. Get rid of those. So we're going to put these lights in, and then I'm going to end the stream for tonight. We will fiddle with the curtains later. Alright, so the kitchen's almost done. It's perfect. The lighting there is a little off though. Gonna put that shelf there. It kind of blends into the fridge. That way we can put some plants there. But we'll do that later. Alright, so that is gonna be the end of the stream for tonight. I'm going to save this and we can continue later. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Bye.